everybody. This is Jordan from the Maysville Public Library, and today we're going to do a story time and craft activity. And the book that we're going to be reading is The Antlered Ship. So let's get started. The Antlered Ship by the Fan Brothers. Ooh, such a pretty map. The Antlered Ship. The day the antlered ship arrived, Mirko wondered about the wide world. He had so many questions. Why do some songs make you happy and others make you sad? Why don't trees ever talk? How deep does the sun go when it sinks into the sea? But when he posed these questions to the other foxes, they grew silent. What does that have to do with chicken stew? They would ask. So Mirko went down to the harbor to see the ship. Three deer greeted him at the gangplank. Mirko wasn't surprised to learn that they were lost. We hope to hire a seaworthy crew, explained Sylvia, the captain. I'm afraid we aren't very good sailors. I will join you, Mirko said. He thought to himself, I will search the sea for foxes who know the answers to my questions. A pigeon named Victor volunteered along with his entire flock. We want to have adventures, they cooed. Welcome aboard, Captain Sylvia said. We're going to a wonderful island with tall, sweet grass and short, sweet trees. When we get there, we'll eat a delectable dinner. But the voyage was more difficult than anyone expected. It rained, waves crashed over the sides of the deck. Why is water so wet, Mirko wondered. The pigeons weren't used to the hard work of raising and lowering the sails. After the first day, they went below decks to play checkers and stayed there. The deer worried about sharp rocks and fierce pirates and feeling seasick. They huddled in the bow and waited for something bad to happen. After days of drifting and dining on crackers, the animals were damp and cranky. We should have stayed in the woods, Sylvia said. Deer aren't supposed to go to sea. We should have stayed in the park, added Victor. Pigeons aren't supposed to do hard labor. Mirko eyed the deer and the pigeons. Foxes aren't supposed to be vegetarian, he said. Still, we must do the best we can. That evening, Mirko found a recipe book in the galley and cooked a warm and reviving stew. Should we look at the charts, he asked, after everyone had eaten. We might find adventure here, said Victor, and trouble here, said Sylvia, but we'll find the island with tall, sweet grass and short, sweet trees here. And perhaps foxes too, Mirko thought. Foxes with answers. As they plotted their course, the wind picked up, the storm clouds thinned into marvelous swirls. Raise the sails, Sylvia cried. In the morning, they came into the maze of sharp rocks. Each one large enough to tear the bottom from the boat. But the pigeons flew ahead, tracing a path through the shoals and sharp rocks to the safety of the open sea. The next afternoon, a pirate ship burst from behind a rocky island. Turn over your treasure, the pirate captain bellowed, or we'll put a hole in your helm. Lower the antlers, Sylvia commanded. The ships clashed and crashed and smashed until the pirates turned and fled. That evening, an island appeared on the horizon with tall waving grasses and short swaying trees. We found it, Sylvia cried. We've triumphed, Victor cooed. Do you see any foxes? Mirko asked. The deer grazed the grass and nibbled the trees. The pigeons told stories of their adventures to a flock of admiring seagulls. Mirko scoured the island for foxes, but he didn't find any. I have failed, Marco told Sylvia. No foxes, no one to answer my questions. What questions? Asked Victor. Marco took a deep breath. Do islands like being alone? Do waves look more like horses or swans? And what's the best way to find a friend you can talk to? That last one's easy, Sylvia said. You make friends by eating together. I disagree, said Victor. You make friends by having adventures together. Maybe you're both right, Marco said, but I think you make friends by asking them questions. Well then, mused Sylvia, should we head home tomorrow, or should we visit the island of scrumptious shrubbery? Are two adventures enough, asked Victor, or should we have at least one more? Is it better to know what's going to happen, wondered Marco, or better to be surprised? There were so many questions left to answer, and so many more to ask. So in the morning, they raised the anchor and hoisted the heavy sails. They knew now that the wind would come and go, the clouds would sometimes make marvelous swirls and sometimes make them wet, and that everything they hoped to find could be found aboard an antlered ship on the way to wherever they were going. The end. That book. It's one of my personal favorites, and it's brand new, and I believe that you guys are the first people to hear me read it, so that's pretty special. So what we're going to do for our craft today is we're going to try and recreate the antlered ship from the book. Here's my little example, and we'll just, I'll walk you through it. So the things that you should have in your kit are I believe that it'll actually be a circle with the holes cut out. And the first thing that you're going to do is you're going to fold it in half. And this is obviously going to be the base of our ship. And then the next thing that we are going to do is we are going to take our yellow rectangles and we're going to glue them to the sides of our ship. Just like that. And then we're going to do it on the same on the other side. And if you want to recreate this again after you've used our craft kit, it'd be really cool if you had like a pink boat with like blue rectangles. That'd be really pretty. I'd love to see that. If anybody does that, I want you guys to tag me in it on Facebook, okay? And the next thing we're going to do is we're going to take, you should have 6 black dots, circles, and we are going to glue those 3 on each side onto our yellow rectangles. Try not to get glue everywhere. Just like so, I'm sure yours will be much more even than mine. But that's okay. Our antlered ship just needs to be able to set sail. Doesn't necessarily have to look super, super pretty. It's unique. Alrighty, one more. Alright, all done. What we're going to do is we're going to cut a cross section on the top of our ship so that the mast can go there. And remember guys, please make sure that you have a parent around whenever you're cutting, if not to at least watch you and help you, if not to, you know, do it for you. Always be safe. So we're going to first do a straight cut right there. And then we are going to open it up slightly, and you're going to put your scissors into the cut that you've made. Let's see. And you may have to make the slit a little bit deeper depending on how big your scissors are. You guys at home are probably using smaller scissors that will probably go in much easier than mine. And then you're going to get your scissors in there and make a, basically you're going to make a cut right along the back of the ship. So that your mask can just slide right in there. Alright, so it should look like you have like an X on the top of your ship. And then you're just going to take your popsicle stick and you're going to slide it into the hole that you made. And it might take some persuasion. Ta-da! And you might notice this problem. It might droop and be sad, and it doesn't look much like a ship when it does that. So, what we're going to do is we're going to take our rectangle that's the same color as our ship, and we're going to add a little bit of support. So what we're going to do is we're basically, on the side that does not have any holes, we are going to glue this inside. So we're going to kind of fold it in. And glue it like this. And you can tuck it in as much as you want or leave it out as much as you want, but we're going to glue it in on the inside. Our mast is too heavy, we need a little bit extra support. Tap, tap. Ta-da! And see, now it stands up perfectly. And now, what you're going to do is you're going to, I've already done it, but you're going to get a small rectangle of paper, or I guess more of like a fat rectangle of paper for your sail. And now is the time if you wanted to write anything on your sail, you know, a skull and crossbones, a heart, or if you wanted to write something like I love summer reading or I love the library, that'd be a pretty cool thing to do, I think so. And you're going to cut some small slits on each end, and then you just slide it in, pretty much. Now, if you want this to, last longer through more playtime, now would be the time to glue it if you would like. Otherwise, if it's going to just sit and look beautiful, then you can just leave it like that. Anything that I have done, you can glue it if it needs to, if you want it to stay a little bit better. And that's how you make your antlered ship. Oh, I forgot the antlers. How am I gonna forget? Now it's just a ship right now. So, in your craft kit, you're going to have a brown pipe cleaner, and now is really up to you. You're just going to feed it through the two holes, and this is when you can be, another chance during this craft where you can be creative. I just kind of bent mine several times to make it vaguely look like a set of antlers, and like so. And then bend it again. Make them look vaguely symmetrical. And then you can kind of fan them out, however you want to do them. And then that's it. Yeah, that's how you make your antler chip.